lecture. In this lecture, we'll take a review of vector algebra. In physics, we categorize physical quantities into two kinds. A physical quantity can be categorized as a scalar or a vector, depending that does it require magnitude, direction, or both for its understanding. A scalar quantity is that which can be fully understood through its magnitude only. We do not require any direction to fully understand it. A vector quantity is that which will have a magnitude and a direction as well, so that we can fully understand the operations of a vector quantity if we associate direction as well as magnitude. If I take Q as a physical quantity and express it as the product of a numerical value and a unit, then a quantity like temperature, which could be 100 degrees centigrade, mass, which could be 20 kg, time, which could be 30 seconds, work, say 100 joule. Now in all these cases, you find that there is a numerical value and there is a unit. Degree centigrade is unit for measuring temperature, kg is unit for measuring mass, second is unit for measuring time, joule is unit for measuring work. So there is no mention of direction, and when we work with different physical phenomena, we are able to add them, subtract them, multiply them by using the normal algebra of numbers, that is scalar algebra. Now when it comes to a physical quantity like displacement or force, here something becomes again mandatory. If I say a displacement of 100 meter, this 100 meter until and unless I associate a direction with it does not become fully understandable. So 100 meter east, 20 meter west, we can think of displacement of a body. A force acting on an object, say it is 10 newton upwards or 10 newton downwards. So this upwards, downwards, at an angle of 45 degree with respect to x-axis, at an angle of 60 degree with respect to x-axis. These are all association of direction with the force. So until and unless we associate the direction with this type of quantity, its actual existence and its combination with other quantities does not become very clear. Aapke lower classes mein ye jo classification hai, this you have taken up, or you can understand ki jab hum scalars ko add karne ki baat karte hain, subtract karne ki baat karte hain, the sufficient knowledge we have is ki ek number line par jis tarah se hum numbers ki baat karte hain, और इन नंबर्स को हम चाहे पॉजिटिव लें या नेगेटिव लें, तो इट इज लाइक दैट कि इफ आई से अ टाइम ऑफ 30 सेकंड प्लस अ टाइम ऑफ 20 सेकंड, सो 30 सेकंड प्लस 20 सेकंड, सो फ्रॉम द नॉलेज ऑफ एडिशन वी अंडरस्टैंड इट इज 50 सेकंड्स। इफ आई से अ मास ऑफ 3 केजी प्लस 4 केजी, इट इज 7 केजी। But when it comes to adding vector quantities, so if it was a force of 3 newton east, so this is 3 newton east, added to a force of 4 newton north, you don't expect the answer to be 7. If we find the answer in this case, to answer kuch aisa ho jayega, it may be a force of 5 newton in a direction which is neither east nor north. So, if we give a definition, a physical quantity is a scalar quantity if it has a magnitude, no direction, and it is sufficiently understood through its magnitude. The rules of addition of scalars are same as the rules of adding real numbers. Whereas a vector quantity is that which has a magnitude, which has a direction, and it has to obey the rules of vector algebra, or it has to obey the rules of vector addition. Ek exception is a zero vector whose magnitude is zero and its direction is arbitrary. That we will consider as a special vector later, but right now we have a general requirement ki ek vector quantity ke liye magnitude ka hona, direction ka hona aur vector rules ko follow karna mandatory hai, compulsory hai. Now what are these vector rules of addition? There is a very simple rule through which vectors add, or before we come to that rule, jisko hum triangle law kehte hain, we give a geometrical representation to a vector. Now a geometrical representation to a vector is through a straight line. Is straight line ko hum ek directed line segment mante hain. If I call it as a vector AB, this vector AB is represented by the directed line segment jiski ek length hai. That length is the representative of magnitude of vector or ek direction hai, so we can define the direction of the vector through this arrow. So assuming ki agar ye AB ek displacement hai, so if I call this as a displacement of 3 meter towards east, or I take, if it is 3 units of length, then I take 4 units of length and call it as 4 meter to the direction of north. So that way is 3 unit of length or 4 unit length ko कंबाइन करके मुझे यहाँ एक रिजल्ट मिल सकता है विच इज थर्ड साइड ऑफ दिस ट्राइंगल जिसकी लेंथ होगी 5 मीटर. हाउ डज इट हैपन लाइक दैट? इसके लिए हमारे पास एक बड़ा ही सिंपल रूल है विच वी कॉल एज ट्राइंगल ऑफ एडिशन. नाउ व्हाट ट्राइंगल ऑफ एडिशन वी इनिशियली टेक अप इज, हम डिस्प्लेसमेंट्स की एग्जाम्पल तो लेते हैं, लेकिन अगर डिस्प्लेसमेंट एक नेचुरल वेक्टर है फिर बाकी वेक्टर्स को भी यही पैटर्न फॉलो करना होगा. इन अदर वर्ड्स, दिस कुड बी लेटर यूज्ड फॉर वेलोसिटीज, इट कुड बी यूज्ड फॉर एक्सेलरेशन, इट कुड बी यूज्ड फॉर फोर्सेस, बट इनिशियली वी स्टेट इट फॉर डिस्प्लेसमेंट्स एज सच. तो आई कैन से कि अगर हमारे पास एक ऑब्जेक्ट है विच स्टार्ट्स इट्स मोशन फ्रॉम ए पॉइंट ओ, सो दिस इज पॉइंट ओ, एंड गोज टू अ पॉइंट ए, सो दिस इज ओ टू ए, and then turns towards point B, what was the net displacement of this object? Very simple to find. कि अगर से यहाँ से पहले यहाँ तक travel किया, फिर यहाँ मुड़ गया इधर की तरफ, finally it has come to rest here. So the net displacement of this object is this line, यहाँ से लेके यहाँ. So I can say that if its first part of displacement was represented by vector OA, and then this vector OA was to be added to vector AB, the resultant would be a vector. That vector is equal to OB. This is OB. That means जो इसकी net displacement है, that is from O to B. तो इस पूरी process में आप देखोगे कि I am trying to construct a triangle, which is not necessary कि एक 90 degree angle हो. ये ऐसा भी हो सकता है that this is O, this is A, this is B, and this is OB. ये ऐसा भी हो सकता है दैट दिस इज ओ, दिस इज ओ, दिस इज ए, एंड दिस इज बी, दिस इज ओ बी. दिस रिजल्ट विल रिमेन ट्रू इन ऑल दीज केसेस. सो व्हाट दिस रिजल्ट सेज, इट सेज दैट इफ वी आर एबल टू रिप्रेजेंट टू वेक्टर्स इन देयर मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन बाय टू साइड्स ऑफ अ ट्राइंगल टेकन इन द सेम ऑर्डर, सो हियर द ऑर्डर इज एंटी क्लॉकवाइज, देन the third side of this triangle, which is the closing side of the triangle, taken in the opposite order. So, agar ye anti-clockwise hai, this is clockwise. Agar ye anti-clockwise hai, this is clockwise. That third side represents the resultant of these two vectors. Notation mein, if I call this as vector A, I call this as vector B, then this is vector C. So, I could say that vector A plus vector B is equal to vector C. This is triangle of addition. तो इस triangle law को हम एक fundamental tool मानते हैं और इस triangle law से हम एक और result derive कर सकते हैं which we call as parallelogram law addition. So what is now so far very significant is कि एक vector की जो representation है with the help of a line segment, that line segment leads us to the formation of triangles when we are trying to add two vectors, or if it is now that we have more than two vectors, to hum unko pehle do vectors, suppose I have a sequence of vectors A plus B plus C plus D and so on, to main in do ko pehle triangle rule set kar sakta hu, triangle law set kar sakta hu. जो इन दो का रिजल्टेंट होगा उसको इसमें ऐड कर देंगे, जो फिर इन दो का रिजल्ट आएगा उसको इसमें ऐड कर देंगे. तो सीक्वेंशियली यू कैन गो ऑन एडिंग एनी नंबर ऑफ वेक्टर्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ ट्रायंगल लॉ. बट समटाइम्स पर्टिकुलरली इन केस ऑफ फोर्सेस व्हिच एक्ट एट ए गिवन पॉइंट, इट बिकम्स इजियर कन्वीनियंट टू अप्लाई द पैरेललोग्राम लॉ एडिशन ऑफ वेक्टर्स. सो वी विल स्टेट नाउ द पैरेललोग्राम लॉ एडिशन ऑफ वेक्टर्स. और प्रायर टू दैट we say that two vectors are said to be equal if their magnitudes are equal and their directions are same. So that way a vector A and vector B are said to be equal if their magnitudes are equal. That means they are represented by two line segments of equal length in the same direction. So if we have the vectors whose magnitudes may be equal but direction is not same, they are unequal vectors. Yeah, two vectors whose magnitudes may be same but directions are not same, they are not equal vectors, they are unequal vectors. So we will use the property of equal vectors and triangle law to arrive upon the parallelogram law addition of vectors. So we take up now parallelogram law of addition of vectors. Assume that I have a vector A, I have a vector B, and this is a vector C. तो अभी तक हम इन तीन वेक्टर्स को अगर ट्रायंगल लॉ से डील करते हैं, आई कैन से दैट सी वेक्टर इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी. बट आई कैन डू वन थिंग कि अगर मैं इसको ओ कहूं, दिस इज ए, दिस इज पॉइंट सी, और यहां इसको एक कंप्लीट पैरेललोग्राम में ड्रॉ कर लेता हूं. सो आई हैव कंप्लीटेड दिस पैरेललोग्राम. अब देखिए इस पैरेललोग्राम में जो ये वेक्टर है एसी वेक्टर, इट वुड बी इक्वल टू, आई कॉल दिस एज बी, सो इट वुड बी इक्वल टू ओबी वेक्टर. व्हाई? बिकॉज़ द टू अपोजिट साइड्स ऑफ अ पैरेललोग्राम आर इक्वल इन मैग्नीट्यूड एंड दे हैव द सेम डायरेक्शन बिकॉज दे आर पैरेलल टू ईच अदर. सो इन दैट सेंस इस प्रॉपर्टी को मैं यूज कर सकता हूं कि ये जो वेक्टर है ये इक्वल, इसके इक्वल होगा, आई कॉल इट एज बी वेक्टर. अप्लाई द सेम थिंग टू बीसी. That we see that BC vector is same as A vector, so it is same as A vector. So many things will happen now because of the drawing of this parallelogram. Or assume कि ये जो A और B के बीच में angle है, this angle is theta. So many things are going to happen from this diagram. तो उस लिहाज से ये diagram को आप याद रखें. Now from this diagram, the first thing I see is कि instead of writing ये तो A है, ये B है, instead of writing OA and call it as A, AB, AC, call it as B, let me do it like this. I can say that vector C, this is vector C, is equal to OA, OA, ko main A kehta hu, aur ye jo AC vector hai, is AC vector ko main agar replace kar do OB se, so I could say that vector C is still equal to A plus B, or vector C is equal to OA plus OB. So OA represents vector A and OB represents vector B. So I can say that this vector C is equal to OA plus OB. Now I interpret this result by saying that if I have a parallelogram in which two vectors A and B to be added are represented in their direction and magnitude by two adjacent sides of the parallelogram, then their resultant or sum is given by the vector which is represented by the diagonal of that parallelogram passing through their initial point. ये वेक्टर का इनिशियल पॉइंट कहलाता है, जिसकी तरफ एरो, दैट्स कॉल्ड एज टर्मिनल पॉइंट. तो इन दो वेक्टर्स के जो इनिशियल पॉइंट्स हैं, दे आर जॉइंड टुगेदर, और वी सी कि जो वेक्टर सी है वो इन दोनों का रिजल्टेंट बन सकता है इफ वी हैव द टू वेक्टर्स बीइंग रिप्रेजेंटेड इन मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन बाय टू साइड्स ऑफ द पैरेललोग्राम. और ये साइड्स अपोजिट नहीं, दे आर एडजेसेंट साइड्स, एडजेसेंट साइड्स. नाउ इन दिस मैनर, अगर हम ये मान के चलें कि एक वेक्टर सी जो डायगनल है उसको हम रिजल्ट मानते हैं, और हमारे पास जो दो वेक्टर्स ए एंड बी हैं, दे आर द टू एडजेसेंट साइड्स ऑफ द पैरेललोग्राम, जिनके बीच में एक एंगल ए है, तो हम अब इस ओ सी या सी वेक्टर का मैग्नीट्यूड निकाल सकते हैं. तो इफ आई वर्क आउट द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दिस, इट कैन बी डन वेरी सिंपली बाय ड्रॉइंग or extending OA, then from here I draw a line which is perpendicular on OA produced, or ye line jo hai, let me call this point as D. So you will agree ki I have now a right triangle OCD, OCD. In this right triangle, if I use Pythagoras theorem, so I find OC square, hypotenuse square is equal to OD square, OD is the base, plus CD square. So this is Pythagoras theorem. Next, I can write OC square is equal to OD. Dekhiye, OD can be written as OA plus AD whole square plus CD square. I can open out this bracket, which makes it OA square plus AD square plus twice OA into AD. So this is A square plus B square plus 2AB plus CD square. Now I can combine AD square with CD square, that will be AC square. So AD square plus CD square, this will be AD square plus CD square will be equal to AC square. So I can write it as OA square plus AD square plus CD square. I combine, make it AC square plus 2 into OA into AD. Now you'll see from the diagram, ki jo OA hai, that is equal to A, that means it is magnitude of vector A. Aur jo AC hai, that is magnitude of vector B plus B square plus 2 into, jo OA hai, that is magnitude of A into, now this AD I can write in terms of theta and B vector. So I can say कि अगर ये angle मैं लूँ, ये angle और ये angle, they are corresponding angles equal to each other, call it as theta, then I have from this right triangle CAD. So right triangle CAD, I can express cos theta is equal to, so this is cos theta is equal to base AD divided by AC, AD divided by AC, or AD divided by B, because AC is equal to B. Then I have, therefore, AD equal to, so this is B cos theta. Now if I substitute AD equal to B cos theta, I have OC square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2A, and this AD I replace by B cos theta, so it is B cos theta. So a result follows that OC becomes equal to under root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So ye jo result hai, this result has now given us the magnitude of this vector C, which is under root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. This is commonly called as cosine formula in the mathematics. Here in vector algebra, we have a very important utility of this result, कि जब भी हमें दो vectors का resultant निकालना है, उस vectors के resultant का जो magnitude है, that magnitude is square root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. और theta, you understand, is the angle subtended between the vectors A and B. Now we can also introduce an angle which C vector subtends with one of the vectors called as the angle subtended by C vector with A vector. I call it as alpha. Now again, from right triangle OCD, OCD, I can obtain tan alpha. So tan alpha is equal to perpendicular CD divided by base. Base is OD, OD. I can talk of now tan alpha as the tan of angle subtended by resultant vector with respect to vector A. And it becomes, you can see that CD, agar aap is right triangle ko lete ho fir se, so you will obtain the value for CD. Aap dekh sakte hain yahan par ki CD is perpendicular aur jo ye hai this AC, it is the hypotenuse. So sin theta is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is AC. So CD will be equal to AC sin theta. Aur AC ko aap dekh le, that AC is magnitude of vector B, so it is B sin theta. So I can substitute CD equal to B sin theta divided by OD. आप देख सकते हैं OD is equal to A plus, ये OD is equal to OA plus AD, so OA is equal to A plus AD. AD हम already prove कर चुके हैं, so AD is equal to B cos theta, so therefore tan alpha becomes equal to B sin theta divided by A plus B cos theta. और ये जो relation है, this relation gives you the value of alpha in terms of A, B and theta. So you can determine the direction and magnitude of vector C by using this and this. So on this, you can solve a number of problems. जैसे मैं कहूँ कि there is a vector of 10 meter this displacement combined with say 5 meter displacement, find the net displacement if the angle theta acting between them, so this is the angle theta acting between A and B. Chahe aap yahan se dekh le, A and B, so this is the direction of A vector, this is the direction of B vector, ya chahe aap yahan se dekh le, this is the direction of A vector, this is the direction of B vector. So if I give this angle theta equal to 60 degree, I give a magnitude of A, I give a magnitude of B, you can determine C. Aur C ka aap magnitude bhi nikal sakte hain aur direction bhi nikal sakte hain. Direction would be the value of alpha. And then you can work out with number of cases. Suppose theta is equal to 0 degree. So ye 0 ho jayega sara. That way this will become A square plus B square plus 2AB, or it will become A plus B whole square. That is under root A plus B whole square. So A plus B ho jayega. If theta becomes 180 degree, you can accordingly see ki ye to 0 ho jayega. Here this will be cos 180 degree is minus 1. So this will be A minus B whole square. Similarly, if theta is equal to 90 degree, so you can work out different cases on this relation. So this is about the addition of vectors. We can now also work out formula for subtraction of two vectors. Subtraction ke liye aap kya karoge? That instead of using the diagonal, jo diagonal in two vectors ke initial point se pass hoti hai, let me draw another diagonal of this parallelogram. So ye ek diagonal mein draw kar raha hu. The diagonal is BA. Now see from the triangle law what happens. So if I take OB as a vector plus BA, so OB plus BA is equal to, so OB plus BA is equal to OA. When a triangle law use kiya. Now OB you understand is B vector plus BA is equal to OA, you understand is A vector. So BA vector becomes equal to A minus B. So ye jo red line aap dekh rahe hain, this is the representation of A minus B vector. Agar hum iski length ko nikal paaye, that will represent the magnitude of vector A minus B. So length of this BA vector represents the magnitude of A minus B. Let's work it out. So as such, main yahan se ek perpendicular draw kar raha hu point B se. So I draw this perpendicular on this line, or इस अल्फा को मैं थोड़ी देर के लिए रब कर लेता हूँ, लेट मी रब इट ऑफ। सो यू विल सी कि जो ये रेड डॉटेड लाइन आप देख रहे हैं और ये सी डी लाइन, दे आर बोथ इक्वल इन लेंथ। वी हैव ऑलरेडी शोन कि जो ये सी डी है, दिस विल बी दिस सी डी, वी हैव ऑलरेडी शोन दैट इट इज इक्वल टू बी साइन थीटा। सो दिस इज बी साइन थीटा, सी डी के बराबर ये लेंथ। और इफ आई वॉन्ट नाउ टू यूज पाइथागोरस थ्योरम अगेन, आई सी दैट बी ए स्क्वेयर, बी ए स्क्वेयर विच इज हाइपोटेन्यूज स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू बेस, बेस अब मैं यहां से ले लेता हूं, लेट मी कॉल दिस पॉइंट ई। सो इट इज बेस, दैट इज ई ए स्क्वेयर, बेस ई ए स्क्वेयर प्लस परपेंडिकुलर, परपेंडिकुलर इज बी ई स्क्वेयर, बी ई स्क्वेयर। सो इफ आई थिंक ऑफ नाउ बी ए स्क्वेयर इक्वल टू ई ए, ये ई ए, सो ई ए यू विल एग्री इज इक्वल टू ओ ए, ओ ए माइनस ओ ई, माइनस ओ ई होल स्क्वेयर प्लस बी। सो नाउ बी ए स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू, दिस इज ए माइनस बी होल स्क्वेयर, सो दैट इज ओ ए स्क्वेयर प्लस ओ ई स्क्वेयर माइनस टू इंटू ओ ए इंटू ओ ई। सो ए स्क्वेयर प्लस बी स्क्वेयर माइनस टू ए बी प्लस बी ई स्क्वेयर। आई कंबाइन नाउ ओ ई स्क्वेयर विद बी ई स्क्वेयर, सो गो टू द डायग्राफ। सो दिस इज ओ ई स्क्वेयर प्लस बी ई स्क्वेयर, दैट गिव्स यू ओ ई स्क्वेयर प्लस बी ई स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू ओ बी स्क्वेयर। सो दैट वे ओ ए स्क्वेयर प्लस ओ बी स्क्वेयर माइनस टू इंटू ओ ए इंटू ओ ई। लेट्स रिटर्न द वैल्यूज टू दिस, ओ ए यू कैन सी फ्रॉम द डायग्राम इज ए स्क्वेयर प्लस ओ बी यू कैन सी इन द डायग्राम इज बी स्क्वेयर माइनस टू इंटू ओ ए, ओ ए इज अगेन ए एंड ओ ई एज आई सेड कि जो ओ ई है हमारे पास, दिस ओ ई वी कैन यूज द ज्योमेट्री हेयर कि अगर मैं इस ट्राइंगल को लेता हूँ, ट्राइंगल ओ ई बी, सो आई हैव राइट ट्राइंगल, राइट ट्राइंगल ओ ई बी, ओ ई बी। इन दिस राइट ट्राइंगल यू विल एग्री कि इफ आई टेक द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस थीटा इज इक्वल टू ओ ई, ओ ई डिवाइडेड बाय हाइपोटन्यूज, हाइपोटन्यूज इज बी, सो ओ ई बिकम्स इक्वल टू बी कॉस थीटा। दैट वे आई कैन सब्स्टिट्यूट ओ ई इक्वल टू बी कॉस थीटा। एंड फाइनली बी ए विच इज मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ए माइनस बी इज इक्वल टू, इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ, तो मैंने स्क्वेयर रूट ले लिया इसका, ए स्क्वेयर प्लस बी स्क्वेयर माइनस टू ए बी कॉस थीटा। दिस इज sufficient for understanding that if we are supposed to subtract two vectors, then it is square of magnitude of the first vector plus square of magnitude of the second vector minus 2 into magnitude of the first vector, magnitude of second vector and cos theta, theta is angle between the two vectors. So you can utilize this knowledge for subtracting two vectors given in this form. A very commonly asked प्रॉब्लम इज कि अगर हमारे पास दो वेक्टर्स हैं ए और बी, सच दैट मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ देयर सम इज इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ देयर डिफरेंस, देन व्हाट इज एंगल बिटवीन, फाइंड एंगल बिटवीन ए एंड बी, सो बिटवीन वेक्टर ए एंड वेक्टर बी। रिमेंबर कि वेक्टर से भी आप सॉल्व करते हैं, द ज्योमेट्री इज वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट। तो अगर मैं यही डायग्राम, जिस डायग्राम के बेसिस पर हमने अभी जिसको हमने पैरेललोग्राम लॉ कहा, तो अगर मैं पैरेललोग्राम लॉ को यूज करूं, सो दिस इज ए प्लस बी, दिस इज ए, दिस इज बी एंड दिस वेक्टर इज ए माइनस बी, सो दिस इज ए माइनस बी, ए माइनस बी। सो हाउ वुड यू वर्क आउट, हाउ वुड यू वर्क आउट द इक्वेशन कि मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ए प्लस बी बिकम्स इक्वल टू मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ ए माइनस बी। It would simply mean that this parallelogram turns into a rectangle such that this diagonal A minus B, which is the diagonal representing difference of the two vectors, ये हमारे पास vector A है, ये vector B है, and this diagonal, the diagonal which represents A plus B, so this is A plus B, A plus B, that the two diagonals become equal. When these two diagonals representing A minus B and A plus B become equal, you are reminded कि ये दो ही तरह possible है. Either this diagram should be a rectangle, or अगर A और B magnitude में equal हैं, then it can be a square. Either way, you will see that the angle between vector A and vector B becomes 90 degree. So without making any calculations, I can say that A must be perpendicular to B to satisfy this condition. Or else, you could have worked out like this, कि under root of A square plus B square plus 2ab cos theta, which gives magnitude of sum of the two, is equal to under root of a square plus b square minus 2ab cos theta, which gives difference of the two, removing the root, that means by squaring both sides, a square, b square, b square will get cancelled on both sides. So I have 2ab cos theta is equal to minus 2ab cos theta, or 4ab cos theta is equal to 0, by assuming ki neither A is 0, nor B is 0, nor 4 is 0, you get cos theta equal to 0 by shifting 4AB to the right hand side, and therefore theta must be equal to 90 degree. So given that if magnitude of sum of two vectors is equal to magnitude of their difference, then the angle between them has to be 90 degree. You can prove this geometrically as well as analytically. It's now also possible that if we think of the sum of two vectors, the sum of two vectors which is given by sum of two sides of a triangle, that way whenever I think of two sides of a triangle, the sum of two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. So think of this now. Ye hamare paas ek vector A hai, ye hamare paas ek vector B hai, aur ye vector C hai. Even though they are represented in their magnitude and direction by three sides of the triangle, but you will always say that sum of two sides of a triangle is always greater than third side. So if I take magnitude of A to this, I add magnitude of B, I am adding the length of two sides of a triangle, it has to be greater than C. This becomes a very important property in case of vector addition. We call it as a triangle inequality. So this is a triangle inequality. In one case, if these two vectors A and B, they lie along the same direction, that means agar B ki direction aisi ho jati hai, then they could be equal to C. That means we can have an equality sign in that case. Otherwise, the magnitude, or if we take sum of magnitude of two vectors, it's always greater than the vector C. Or I can also state it like this, that if I take magnitude of sum of A and B, then it is greater than or equal to C. Aap mante hain ki C vector is magnitude wise equal to A plus B. So this is magnitude wise A plus B. This is a very important property which we utilize later in the physical phenomena, that sum of the magnitudes of two vectors is always greater than or equal to the magnitude of their sum, triangle inequality. Now you can pause the video and solve the problems as shown. Also, you can take some more problems of the same type related to this concept and solve them.